كل مكان الصورة زينت البلدان زورون رجع فرحان كفى بينو للهلولة حد استحطو محيلة ضربو شوفارة الليلة
شالوم برخة I would like to wish you Shana Tova and Bracha Be'atzlacha and Briyut for all of you, your families. And today I would like to talk about the special parasha that we read on Rosh Hashanah. On Rosh Hashanah, as you know, there is 10 days between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, 10 days. Those 10 days represent the Ten Commandments, that we should not forget that we received the Torah, and why we have Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, because Hashem gave us laws to respect, and unfortunately, there is a lot of laws that we did not respect. So, Hashem gave us those 10 days. This is the reason why we blow the shofar on Rosh Hashanah. Why? Because, as you know, on Rosh Hashanah, we blow the shofar. But we do remember the Torah said that when Hashem gave us the Torah, during the Ten Commandments, the Jewish people did hear the shofar. Why the shofar? Why Hashem used the shofar during Matan Torah? What was the reason? Why? So I think the reason it's easy. The reason of the shofar was that Hashem he want to give an advice to the Jewish people. Here is I give you the Torah, and I know there is the Yetzer. I know that that in life is impossible to be honest that you will respect all the laws that I give you. It's impossible. You know, don't tell me that every person who lives in his country that he respects the laws of the country. I mean, about the tax, about this. I mean, people, they try a lot of times, the limit how fast you can drive, and sometimes people they drive a little bit faster, then the police arrest them, and so they have a penalty. So in life there is always penalties. It's impossible to be perfect. It's impossible to be perfect. So Hashem knows that to be perfect with Hashem it's impossible. So Hashem he said, well, I give you 10 days between Rosh Hashanah and Kippur that you can repair, you can do Teshuvah. And the reason why we did sin, because of the Yitzhara. So Hashem said, okay, Shippur, I mean, improvement. The shofar from the word Shippur. Shippur, that means to improve yourself. Hashem gave us 10 days a year that we can improve yourself. Give us Elul, the month of Elul is preparation, and then the 10 days between Rosh Hashanah and Kippur to improve a little bit ourselves. This is the reason why we blow the shofar on Rosh Hashanah, and during the 10 days of Atzeret Yemei B'Teshuvah from Rosh Hashanah till Yom Kippur, we blow every morning with the Slichot, the shofar, and on Yom Kippur, when Kippur finish, we blow the shofar again. It's like Hashem asks us to improve ourselves. So that means the day that Hashem give us the Torah, Hashem he make us hear the sound of the shofar. That in case that you will not respect mitzvot, so you can blow the shofar. The shofar is to remind you Shippur, to get better, improve yourself. And Baruch Hashem, thanks God, I have to tell you this. Since I am 70 years old now, this is the first year in my life that I felt Rosh Hashanah very, very well. And I was not in shul because I did Rosh Hashanah with a special minyan, 13 people in my house. We use the Sefer Torah, we use the shofar, and it was the best. A lot of times we feel that to be good, it's only a big shul with hundreds of people. We realize that this corona was not so bad. Why? Because this corona, it gives us a little bit time to think how to get rid of it. To pray more to Hashem, to approve ourselves a little bit more. And I prayed very, very well this Rosh Hashanah. Much more than the previous years. Because at least this time, I had a reason why what to ask from Hashem. Of course, I ask from Hashem forgiveness for all what I did. And I promise Hashem I will improve myself. At the moment that the rabbi was blowing the shofar, I thought about the Torah that was given with the shofar. And the reason why it was given with the shofar is so if I did do something that Hashem forbidden me to do, so I have to improve myself. I did remember that we have 10 days between Rosh Hashanah and Kippur. The 10 is to connect myself to God, to Hashem, through the 10 commandments that He gives us when He gives us the Torah. So, if I understand very well, the Rosh Hashanah and Kippur has a lot to do with Matan Torah, with the donation of the Torah, the day Hashem gives us the Torah. And I have to tell you this. The Torah, it's not Bashamayim, it's not up there. Once a year, when we blow the shofar, we do remember that Hashem gives us the Torah. The Torah was on the Shamayim, on the sky, and Hashem gave it to us on earth. And the same way that when Hashem gave us the Torah, He came down from the Shamayim to earth, what kavod! How much Hashem valued the Jewish people, that He has to come from up there, down here, to give us the Torah on Shavuot. So, my friend, on Kippur, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, He came down again. On Yom Kippur, we do mention Ki Bayom Hazeh, there is a pasuk on the Torah, Ki Bayom Hazeh, on that day, that means the day of Kippur, Yichaper Alechem, Hashem will forgive you, לטהר אתכם, He will make you brand new, מכל חטאותיכם, from all the sin that you did, that לפני Hashem תטהרו, and you will be reminding, you will be standing in front of Hashem. It's incredible, my friend, what I'm telling you now, that Hashem, on the day of Kippur, He is with us. Can you imagine? It's up to us to realize if we do want that Hashem to remain with us the rest of the year, or that's it, only for Yom Kippur. So of course, the best is that we have to remain to be with Hashem for all year. Because if Hashem come from the Shamayim, from up there, down here, He came to stay. He don't come just for a while. He came Yom Kippur. Very good. Now it depends. Do you want Him to stay with you or not? It's up to you. Because Hashem, that's what He wants. The Asuli Mishkan Veshachati Betocham. All what Hashem He wants, He wants to reside, to have His residence on us, on you. So, my friend, on Yom Kippur, at Rosh Hashanah, we prepare ourselves to Yom Kippur. For that real moment that Hashem, He is standing in front of you, and you are in front of Him. On Rosh Hashanah, all of us were up there. Atem nisayivim hayom kulchem. On Rosh Hashanah, all the Jewish people are judged. And all the Jewish people, they are up there. Da'a Rosh Hashanah. But on Yom Kippur, Hashem don't judge us up there. On Yom Kippur, we are down here, and Hashem come down to stay with us. It depends how we prepare ourselves. But He's here. So you see, my friend, that there is a big connection between Matan Torah, the day that Hashem gives the Torah, it was on Shavuot, and Rosh Hashanah and Kippur. Between Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, there is 10 days. We compare those 10 days, the 10 commandments that Hashem gave us on Shavuot. On Shavuot, Hashem, He came down to give us the Torah. On Kippur, Hashem, He came down to forgive us for all the sin that we did. Rosh Hashanah, we blow the shofar. Blowing the shofar to remember, oh, when Hashem gave us the Torah, Hashem, He blow the shofar. Shofar, that means shippur, amelioration, to get a little bit better, to be better than I was last year. This is New Year. I wish you a Shana Tova. I wish you a Happy New Year. What that mean, Happy New Year? That mean that we turn the page. We will not talk about the last year, the terrible year, the corona, etc., etc. Now we wish Happy New Year. We wish a better year, better than the. But by wishing a new year, so we have to renew ourselves as well. Not only the year, not only to wish a new year and that's it. No, you have to be, you as well, a better man, a better person, a new person. And to remember that the Torah, it's not up there. And this is the reason, I think, my friend, this is the reason why on Yom Kippur Hashem, He came down. He was just to remind us, hey, before I give you the Torah, I was up there. And the Torah was up there. Now, the Torah is not up there anymore. It's down here. So I came for the Torah. That means that Hashem, He came down here on Kippur, because Hashem, He knows that we did not respect enough Torah and we did some sin. So Hashem, He came here just to forgive us. Can you imagine that? So we should not refuse His forgiveness. There is a Midrash who said, a beautiful Midrash, a beautiful Midrash, who said, when Hashem gave the Torah to Moshe Rabbeinu, to the Jewish people, the Satan, he came to Hashem. He told him, Hashem, who is the Torah? So Hashem, He said to the Satan, to the Tzara, well, the Torah, it's not anymore here. It's down there. Well, the Satan, he said, what? You give the Torah? All of it? There is nothing left here? Hashem, He said, no. There is nothing left here. Everything is down there. Can you tell me, please, Hashem, where is the Torah? So Hashem, He said to the Satan, go, look for it. So he started to look. The sea and the desert, all the planets, all the stars, he looked for the Torah. He came back to Hashem, he said to Hashem, Hashem, I did not find the Torah. Who is the Torah? So Hashem, He said, well, really, you want to know where is the Torah? Go to Moshe. I give it to Moshe Rabbeinu. And Moshe Rabbeinu, He gave it to the Jewish people. It's not anymore. The Torah is not anymore here. It's down there. So the Satan, he went to Moshe Rabbeinu. And he asked Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe, where is the Torah? So Moshe Rabbeinu, he said to the Satan, to the Yetzirah, the Torah? What are you talking about? What Torah? I don't have any Torah. So the Satan, he went back to Hashem. Hashem, where is the Torah? So Hashem, he said, I told you, I give it to Moshe Rabbeinu. And Moshe Rabbeinu gave it to the Jewish people. There is no more Torah here. So the Satan said to Hashem, Ribono shel Olam, Hashem, I asked Moshe, and Moshe told me he has nothing. What? Hashem said? Moshe told you he has nothing? So you know what Hashem did? He came down, and he asked Moshe, Moshe, who is the Torah? So Moshe Rabbeinu said to Hashem, the Torah? Which Torah? Are you kidding? Are you making fun of me? I give you the Torah. You say I did not give you nothing. So Moshe Rabbeinu said, Ribono shel Olam Hashem, the Torah is yours. The Torah is not a business. The Torah, you did not give me nothing. It's yours. I mean, you give us the Torah, but it belongs to you. I mean, it's not something that you can give. So Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, now that you talk like that, so I give you the Torah. Now I really give you the Torah. It's yours. It's yours. It's not anymore mine. So my friend, the Torah now belongs to us. Torah lo bashamayim. The Torah is not up there. The Torah is down here. The problem is, I have a big question. The Satan. How the Satan didn't see the Torah? I don't understand this discussion between Hashem and the Satan. Hashem, he said to the Satan, it's down here. He came down here, he doesn't find it. Hashem, after he told him, I give it to Moshe Rabbeinu. He came to Moshe Rabbeinu and he don't realize nothing. I mean, how can you imagine this? And then Moshe said, I have nothing. And then Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, how can you say you have nothing? So Moshe said, Hashem, the Torah is not mine, it's yours. And then Hashem told him, now it's yours. How do you understand this? My friend, the Torah is the secret. You know what it is, a secret? A secret that means it's like you have the account number of your bank. A secret. Nobody knows it. Like those numbers that they were in Switzerland a few years ago. That people only knew the number. No name, nothing. And that number, if somebody knows it, he can use it and take all your money. The Torah is secret. The Torah is hidden. You can realize, you can feel the Torah, the light of the Torah, only when you respect it. That way the Satan couldn't see it. The Satan, he cannot see the Torah. He has no approach to the Torah. The Satan, he cannot have a hold on the Torah. He cannot see what it is, the Torah. Only up there he can see the light of the Torah. Up there, the Shamaim can see the light of the Torah. But once Hashem gives the Torah to the Jewish people, so the Satan realized there is something missing up there. Because all the Torah was given to the Jews. So now that all the Torah was given to the Jews, so there is nothing up there. So how the Satan could realize there is the light of the Torah here? You know why? Because the Satan cannot realize the light of the Torah, the beauty of the Torah, only when you study the Torah. When you sit and you study and you do the mitzvot, So the Satan can see that. But as long as you don't do it, the Satan cannot see the light of the Torah, even down here. It's secret. What is the secret? How you can beat the Yetzirah? The secret how you can beat the Yetzirah only through the Torah. Through keeping Torah and mitzvot. This is the weapon. And without it, you cannot beat him. So we have, it's like today, if there is a world war, it's going to be a secret world war. No one knows what kind of weapons the other nation has. So it's a secret. Like today, it's secret. All, every nation, they're working how to get the vaccine for the corona. It's a secret. Because the first nation who will provide the secret of the corona, the vaccine of the corona, he can be a billionaire. Billionaire. Everybody will buy from him. So now they're working very hard. Each one, then unfortunately, each one is trying to have this weapon of the vaccine of the corona. The Torah, it's the weapon. It's the weapon how to fight the Yetzirah. This is the reason why the Yetzirah, the Satan, he was looking in this earth. Because he knows that the Torah is the light. Up there, he saw the light of the Torah. Now, since Hashem, he gave the Torah to earth, if he realized there is no anymore the light of the Torah up there. Torah lo b'Hashem, the Torah is not up there anymore. It's down here. But where it is? He couldn't find it. It's a secret. My friend, this is the weapon secret that we use against the Yetzirah. And the Yetzirah cannot see from where he's beaten. He's getting a missile. This is the Torah Kedusha. And never the Satan will know where is the Torah. Never. He see us with beard. That's it. He see us study Torah. That's it. But we try with us. With the Torah, we send missiles on him. And he doesn't know from where those missiles came and beat him and ran away from us. My friend, unfortunately, when we don't study Torah, when we don't do Torah mitzvot, so the Satan, the Yetzirah, realize how much weak we are and he can beat us. And when we start doing Torah and mitzvot, so, Baruch Hashem, we start to beat him and he doesn't know from where the missiles came. Now we understand, on Rosh Hashanah, the Satan, he come to Hashem to try to do all his best. To tell Hashem that we did not respect our mitzvot. Look how much we acted during the years. We have not been good people. We didn't study Torah. We didn't do mitzvot. We did what we want. And now on Rosh Hashanah we can't ask forgiveness. And we are not good people. So what do we do? We know that we admit that we have not been good people during the year. But what do we do? So we blow the shofar. By blowing the shofar, we remind to the Satan, yes, we receive Torah. The Torah was given with fire. The Torah was given with the shofar. And now we ask Hashem pardon, forgiveness. And when the Satan hear the shofar on Rosh Hashanah, and the shofar during all those weeks, all those days, till Kippur, he ran away. He's mixed up. He feels that the Jewish people just received the Torah now. Kintinata Mer Sinai. He feels that this shofar that we blow on Rosh Hashanah is like Hashem renew Matan Torah again with us. So he ran away. The Gemara said that the day that Hashem gives the Torah to the Jews on Shavuot, the Satan disappeared. The Satan was afraid because Hashem came down. And during those 10 days, the Satan feel Hashem down here. He feel him. So he's worried. And on Kippur, Hashem, he come himself. He come down. You know, my friend, today there is radars to protect the country against missiles. The Satan Israeli has missiles belong to him. So we have the Torah. The Torah is the radar. When we use the Torah, the radar, so we are hit through missiles of the Yitzhara, so we send back an anti-missile. So, and then we send another missile on the Satan himself. So we beat him. But the Satan doesn't stop. He never give up. And Baruch Hashem, HaKadosh Baruch Hu give us the Torah, which is down here, not up there. With the Torah we fight back. And this is our life all year, till 120 years. Sometimes he beat me, sometimes I beat him. But here is Rosh Hashanah and Kippur came, those 10 days, we do a good teshuvah. We elect Hashem as the king. All year, we elect Hashem as the king. But on Rosh Hashanah, till Kippur, we do elect Hashem with the Torah. Especially on Yom Kippur, that Hashem is down here. We re-elect him. So he's very happy. And this is all about from Rosh Hashanah till Kippur. On Kippur, between Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, we have to realize, we have to repeat what we said when Hashem gave us the Torah. When Hashem gave us the Torah, he proposed, he said, do you want the Torah? What we said? We said, Na'ase. We do and we're here. Usually, when they propose you something, you say, yes, I want to. Tell me about the proposition. I want to hear. Then I will tell you if I want or not. I don't say, yes, I accept the proposition. The proposition. Maybe it's not a good proposition. When Hashem said, you want the Torah, the Jewish people said, yes. We do, then we hear. We accept it, yes. Without asking what kind of Torah they want, what kind of Torah Hashem is going to give them. So my friend, on Rosh Hashanah, between Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, we renew Na'aseh V'Nishma. This is the shofar. When we do the shofar on Rosh Hashanah, we remember the shofar that Hashem blow on Matan Torah. And that reminds us, all the bad things that we did this year. So we improve ourselves. So we accept again Na'aseh V'Nishma, again. On Yom Kippur, we compare ourselves more than the angels. The angels are very holy. They are the Shamayim, the sky, but they have no Yitzhara. But we live here, this earth. We have a lot of Yitzhara. There is a Satan. So, our work on Rosh Hashanah till Kippur is to improve ourselves, to elect Hashem as a king. And Hashem, he said, look, all year I was your king. But all year, you did Elect me as a king. Every morning we say Hashem Melech, Hashem Alach, Hashem Loch, La'olam Vaed. Every day. But Hashem, he has an argument. There was no shofar. There was no improvement. Shofar from the word Shippur, improvement. So you make me as a king, but without any improvement. So between Rosh Hashanah till Kippur, we improve ourselves with the shofar. We improve our tefillah. Those 10 days is to improve all what we did wrong during the year. The tefillah that we did wrong, the pray, the mitzvot, the brachot, to improve ourselves. So between Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, we improve all what we did wrong during the year. And we have to remember that Hashem created the world for the Torah. And if we don't, as you know, Hashem, he created the world on the 25th of Elul, and Adam HaRishon was created on Rosh Hashanah. You understand? Hashem, he created Adam on Rosh Hashanah. And Hashem, he created the world five days before, 25th of Elul. And Hashem, he created the world for Adam and to give him the Torah. I mean, what the purpose that Hashem created the world? He created Adam to do what? The purpose to serve him. So we need to serve Hashem. Unfortunately, we do, there is Yetzara. So what we do? We improve ourselves. That's why Rosh Hashanah, the day that Adam was created, we do shofar. Now we need to improve ourselves. How we do improve ourselves? Yom Teruah. Teruah is blowing of the shofar. The word Teruah, it's Torah Ayin. How can we improve ourselves through the Torah that we can read it in 70 ways? Yom Zichron Teruah. We should always remember the day that Hashem created the world. The day that Hashem created Hayom Arat Olam. The day that Hashem created Adam, it was on Rosh Hashanah. And then Hashem, he judged him, and Hashem, he gave him life. And he forgave him. So that we should not forget. That's why on Rosh Hashanah, we do Teshuvah. Hashem judged us like he judged Adam Rishon. On Rosh Hashanah, we blew the shofar. Blowing mean to get better, improvement, to remember that the world is judged on the day of Rosh Hashanah. Everybody is judged. And the same way that Hashem forgive Adam Rishon, he may forgive you, but you have to ask yourself one question. Why you went against God during the year? Because we did not respect enough the Torah. Because Hashem, he created the world for the Torah, for the mitzvot. And if we do not respect them, so it's a problem. On Rosh Hashanah, we will remember the creation of the world. On Rosh Hashanah, we remember the first Shabbat that Hashem, he gave to Adam HaRishon. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday was the creation of the world. And Adam, on Shabbat, the seventh day, Hashem rested. That's why there is one Shabbat before Kippur. We call it Shabbat Shuvah. Because on Shabbat, Adam Rishon did Teshuvah. And we do Teshuvah during these 10 days for all the sins that we did. That they are all have a connection with the Ten Commandments. So you see, my friend, everything is related. I would like to finish with a small story to prove you how much Hashem is fabulous, is fantastic. Every year, I use a special book that talk about Rosh Hashanah. And that special book, it is in my office. Here in Raanana. Now it's 5 years that we have the synagogue. And this year I prayed in my home. We built a tent with 12, 13 people. And then on Friday, before Rosh Hashanah, they started to set, you know, to prepare the shul, chairs, standard, the ark of the Sfarim, everything. Okay, so the man who did the whole work, he told me, Rabbi, do you want your standard or that you use all year? Oh, you want a normal standard, a light one? I said, no, bring me just a light one. I don't want my own standard because it's very heavy. But you know what happened? He bring me the two standards, the my standard, the heavy one, and the light one. I told him, why you did that? He said, well, you rabbi, you choose. Maybe this standard, you use it all year. Maybe you know, use it. I said, but it's very heavy. Well, Rabbi, now it's here, it's here. So, okay. Now, on Rosh Hashanah, I had a lot of pain that I didn't have with me the small white book that I use every Rosh Hashanah, because that book, there is a lot of things about Rosh Hashanah and Kippur. And I was very, very, very sad that I didn't have this. Okay. Suddenly, I don't know what happened to me, and my standard, the heavy one, I open it, and I find there the white book. I was so happy. Now I understand that Hashem knew that I will ask to bring me only a light standard. But Hashem knew that in the heavy standard, there is there my white book. And I will be very upset if I don't find it. So Hashem put in the mind of Mr. Levi to bring me the two standards. So one, the light one, which I will not use, but the heavy one, because there is there the book. My friend, from here understood that Hashem, He knows everything. When Hashem knows that you need something, Hashem already prepared the thing before you ask for it. Because I asked to bring me the light one. But if they bring me the light standard, with no, there is a light, there is nothing there. And they will not bring me the heavy one, because the heavy one, there is there a place where I keep books there. So can you imagine? It's better for them to bring me the light one, not the heavy one. Because the heavy one, 3 people have to hold it. The light one, even a baby will hold it. So why you bring the heavy one? Because the book was there. Because Hashem put it. So my friend, if Hashem, He knows what I need, and He prepared for me to give me what I need before I ask for it. So let's ask to Hashem what we need. Hashem, He can prepare you to give you what you need before you ask for it, only when He knows that you are connected to Him. But if we let Him down all year, we need to ask. We did let Him down all year. So this corona was given to us since last year. But Baruch Hashem, this corona gave us sometimes to think about ourselves, to go back to Hashem. So we need, please God, that this Yom Kippur to pray very, very much to Hashem to forgive us and to take from us this corona. A lot of friends that I know pass away. There is at least 10 rabbis pass away since last week here in Israel from Corona. There is some friends that I have very young, very, very badly unconscious with the Corona. The Corona start again to hit. Well, I'm not happy because I thought that it will reduce on Rosh Hashanah and then Kippur. But I see that it's going stronger and stronger on Yom Kippur, like Pesach. So, on the other hand, I am optimist, Be'ezat Hashem, to give you this good news, please God, with Emuna. Each one of us has to wish to himself a good news. What good news? There is some rabbis, thanks God, that like the Chatam Sofer, the Lubavitch Rebbe, some good rabbis, that they already saw that this year, the 2020, it will be a bad year, but the 2021 will be good year. So Be'ezat Hashem, it's a good news. We have to start Kippur with this good news. Be optimist that we will have good news, Be'ezat Hashem. For the moment, it's not good, because they are even talking that they will close old shuls for Kippur. Maybe Sukkot, we don't know yet, but the year didn't start well. But, okay, Be'ezat Hashem, it will be finished the bad year by Kippur, and we start a good year on Yom Kippur. Chatima Tova, good signature, God bless you, Shana Tova, may Hashem give you all what you need, Be'ezat Hashem. Shalom Baracha, I just want to remind you, as I said before, Torah lo bashamayim. The Torah is not anymore in the sky, but the Torah is from the Shamayim. It's very important to know that. You know, the Torah, she has an effect side. The Torah that we respect the mitzvot, the laws that Hashem give us. So we discovered who is the boss, that is HaKadosh Baruch Hu. You know, my friend, there is secret, some kind of secret in the Torah for those who respect it, because they are the laws of Hashem. Look, when the Torah said that you can do teshuva, if you do bad things, come back to Hashem. How can I come back to Hashem? How? How can Hashem can forgive me for what I did? How can I connect myself to Hashem again? It's impossible. Who I am? I am just a human being. How can I? This is the Torah. The Torah said, "Bishavta ad Hashem Elokecha." There is a pasuk who said, "You can do teshuva," and because there is teshuva, so don't worry. The teshuva, when you decide, the day you decide, the moment you decide to come back to Hashem, you're okay. This is the invisible shield of the Torah. This is the invisible shield of the Torah. I mean, this is you don't see. Look, like the Torah said, if you respect the Shemitah, Hashem, you know what it is, Shemitah? 6 years, you work your field, and the number seven, after 6 years, the year six, seven, you have to give Shabbos to all your fields. You are not allowed to work there. You are not allowed. Let them. So there's a question: what am I going to eat? If I don't work my field to give me food, what? And Hashem said, "Bitziviti it bekati, I will bless the field, your land,
and your land will give you for 3 years. Can you imagine that? I mean, only Hashem can promise you this. Can you imagine somebody will tell me, hey, David, you give tzedakah, and I promise you, you will have this and this and this. I mean, a man today is here, tomorrow he can die, but Hashem not. And the Torah, it's something that it exists all the time. The Torah said, "Utzdakat atzimimavet." You give tzedakah, the tzedakah will save you from death. I mean, only Hashem can promise you this. Only God, only somebody who created the world can give you some kind of promises. Even a king, even a president cannot give promises because today is here, tomorrow he might die. But Hashem is forever. I mean, if the Torah wrote that you can do teshuvah during those days because Hashem is round, so the Torah is from the Shamayim. The Torah has a powerful something. The Torah is not Bashamayim. It's not anymore up there, as I said before. But if she is from up there, then she came here. And that way the tzaddikim are stronger. How way the tzaddikim are stronger? Because the tzaddikim have this strength because of the Torah, the spiritual of the Torah. The ash, the fire of the Torah. Only something Shamaimi mitkayem v'ishlo kiyum. Only something that came from the Shamaim can have, you know, an effect. Something that, something strong on it. So my friend, this is the beauty of the Torah. This is the gift that Hashem give us. And so we will not miss the gift, we will not lose it. So Hashem give us Hoshana Kippur to do Teshuvah, to come back to Him. And He is here with us to help us to do Teshuvah. And Baruch Hashem, we become new people. Hashem bless you. Thank you.